My dear students, here is the lesson on basics on system. I am your course teacher Amit Sandal. Our course title is Continuous Signals and Linear Systems. Previously, we have come to know about the signal, properties of signal, classification of the signals. Now, in this lesson and in this week, we will be familiar with the basic of systems. First of all, what is the system? System is like a processor. Okay, where input and output, where there are multiple input, they may be single input and outputs are there. So a system is an entity that processes one or more input signals in order to produce one or more output signals. That means it's one kind of process, or it is one kind of a processor. Okay, that is this type of things are systems. So whenever you give a certain, what can I say, definition, the thing is the process. As you can see in computer, there are input devices, output devices, and central processing unit. The central processing unit or motherboard is a system. The input devices like keyboard and scanners, and also you can see the mouse, these are the input devices, and output devices are the LCD screen, there may be printer, there may be loudspeakers. These systems are output devices, but the process that comes forward to us, that's known as the system. Classification of systems. There are three major type of classification. That it depends on number of inputs and number of outputs and types of signal that processed. So, as we can see in the previous slide, there is a system that resides in middle of the block. Input in the left side, output in the right side. So, these three entities could give us the classification of system. So according to the number of inputs, a system with one input is said to be single input. A system with one input is said to be single input. A system with more than one input is said to be multiple input system. A system with one output is known as single output. Multiple output means one or more outputs, that is multiple output. And for types of signal, there are two major types. A system can be classified in terms of types of signal that it processes. That means how that can be processed. So consequently, terms such as following with the described signals can also be used to describe system. Just like this, it can be one-dimensional, multi-dimensional. So the system will be changed like this. I can give you an example, one-dimensional and multi-dimensional system. Just look onto your smartphone. Here you can see picture, an image. You took it from a image is took from a camera lens. You have took it from your phone camera, and it is stored onto your device. Whenever you opened it, it is a 2D picture. Okay, it's not a 3D picture that you took. It's 2D picture that you have seen onto the display. These type of things are known as multi-dimensional signal, that means two-dimensional signal, and the system that process this kind of things, that's not a multi-dimensional or two-dimensional system. And now you can ask me, what is the one-dimensional thing? I will say, just it's pretty difficult to understand, but I have an example of one-dimensional system, that is, whenever you input some values to compute in a calculator, just like that, when you use a calculator, you put addition, subtraction, multiplication in a one line or a series of a line, and you get a single output or some the results of the calculation. This is known as one-dimensional signal that goes to it in a binary or any other thing. and the signal that processes in this system is known as one dimensional system. Another thing is that continuous time and discrete time. Continuous time means the time that has no breakage or no delay, not delay, the thing, the word will be, there are some entities in every time. There is no other time that you don't get anything. Okay, that's not continuous time. If you see a continuous time signal like sinusoidal signal, you can see that here in the time axis, in every point of time you have a value. In every point of time you have a value in y axis. You can see every time you can get it every time. But in discrete, you will get certain samples and certain value. Certain samples and certain value. There are gaps. There are gaps between these two. There are samples, different samples. There are gaps between these two. So that is discrete time, and previously is known as the continuous time. Third part is the analog and digital. That means that you know it better, analog signals, and most of the continuous time signals are continuous signals. In analog signal, that has a certain value in certain time, as you can see here. But in the digital signal, you know, in the binary system, that is 0, 1, the digital signals are like that. If you say that is a up voltage, there is a down voltage 0, that can up, that can be down. If you down with the two different steps, you can see that is 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. That is the binary data. If the binary data process in that kind of signal, in that kind of system, is known as a digital system. So a continuous time system processes continuous time signals, and a discrete time system processes discrete time signals. So that a system is mainly determined by its signal, that which signal it processes. Okay, we'll go on to the next slide. That is the block diagram of signal processing system. There are two block diagrams here. First of all, here you can see XT is the signal. So whenever you enter the signal, process a continuous time signal with a discrete time system, if it is a discrete time system, first you have to convert it. You need a converter of continuous to discrete time converter. Then it will be able to process in the discrete time system. And after that, if you want to get continuous time signal again, so you need another converter to convert discrete to continuous. And if you want to process a discrete time signal with a continuous time system, same thing will happen. You have to make the discrete signal to a continuous signal. As you can see, it needs the converter, discrete to continuous. You get the continuous, that is T, and discrete means N. I have told you before, in signals, in signal basics on signals, again it could be processed to get the discrete signal, that is your desired signal. Okay, so you need a converter around both sides. Now coming back to the point of communication systems, that is a communication system. As you can see, there is a message signal. You need a transmitter to transmit this signal to the channel, and channel is the main system here, and it will we have to process here in transmitter to transmit this signal from to the receiver part across the channel. And in the receiver part, there are certain attributes. It's also a system. It will receive the signal and translate the signal, that our desired message that we have, which have been given to the transmitter, and we can estimate the message signal. That is the general structure of a communication system. So the process will have to be remained on the transmitter and receiver side, because in channel we are very less chance to change the channel, because that can be wired or that can be wireless. Okay, so the main system changes relies on transmitter and receiver, not more than that. Here is an example of control systems.